Just now we have seen the different types of survey research based on the time frame. Now we will see the classification of surveys based on the procedure of data collection. While conducting the survey, the tools of the survey like a questionnaire or an interview is given to the participants to get their answers. Depending on how this questionnaire or the interview is conducted, the surveys can be classified as written surveys, oral surveys, and electronic surveys. Let us find out more about these three methods of data collection in a survey. In the written survey, the participants are asked to fill in the questionnaire, which is given in a written form, and the answers are also asked in a written form. However, as per the method, we have three different types of written surveys. One is where the researcher sends the questionnaire through mail or by post, and the participants or the respondents then fill in the questionnaire and send it back through the mail again. Naturally, it can be sent to a large group of respondents, and also therefore the cost is comparatively very low. The only problem here is that all the respondents may not send it back to the researcher. So the other alternative way is inviting the respondents at a particular place and giving them the questionnaire in the group. So naturally, there and then only the respondents will fill in the questionnaire and give it back to the researcher. This saves time as well as cost, but it's very difficult to get all the respondents at a particular place. The next type is dropouts, where the researcher sends or goes personally and gives the questionnaire to the respondent, but then go back again and collect the filled in questionnaire, and therefore it is termed as dropout survey. All these three types are for written answers. Another type of survey is oral survey, where the researcher meets the respondent or talks to the respondent. The mode of connecting the information is by oral. So mostly interviews are conducted in a oral survey form, where the researcher asks the questions and the respondent answers, which can be recorded. There are two types where the researcher can use either face-to-face mode or a telephonic interview. Telephonic interview can be used when the respondents and the researchers are not at the same place. This can be conducted for a single respondent or for a group of respondents. So basically, for an oral survey, interview schedules, structured or unstructured, are used for collecting the data. The third form of collecting the information is by electronic ways. This has been made possible because of the advent of computers and internet in the society. The questionnaire can be sent electronically via email to the respondents, or can be converted into www forms and sent to the respondents. Sometimes these forms are kept at a highly populated area, such that libraries or malls, where the respondents are coming and therefore they can fill in the questionnaire. So we have seen the different ways of collecting information in a survey research, and we have seen that there are four different ways as personal, by telephone, by mail and by electronic. This chart gives you the classification of all the different types of media that is used for data collection in a survey research. After learning through different types of survey and the methods of data collection in the survey, let us come to how to conduct the survey. So, the steps of conducting a survey, where the first step is to decide what type of information is required for a particular type of research question. So, it's necessary as in any other research to decide the objectives of the research. And the next step will be to define the population or the target group, which are the subjects. The next stage is to decide about the resources. What are the different resources that are required in a survey which we want to conduct or the researcher wants to conduct? Naturally, how much is the total time available? What can be the total cost? These questions are to be answered before deciding the method of survey. If we have less time and if we want more participants, then what should be the procedure to go about it? Then the next step comes about deciding and preparing the tool for data collection, whether it should be a questionnaire, whether it should be an interview schedule. All of these decisions as well as preparation of the tool for data collection is to be decided and developed. Since most of the surveys, the researcher is not face to face with the respondents, it is necessary to develop clear instructions for the respondents to fill in the questionnaire. Then the next stage comes as selection of the sample. The sample should be truly representative of the population. That means every member of the sample selected should have, or every member of the population should have an equal chance of getting selected in the sample. Therefore, surveys mostly use random selection methods for sampling. Once the tool is developed and the sample is selected, the reliability and the validity of the tool needs to be determined. For this purpose, a small group from the population is selected, which is not included in the sample selected. After administering the tool to this small group, the validity and reliability of the tool is decided as per any other method or in any other tool. In a survey, since the respondents are not known to the researcher or since they are not face to face with the researcher, a letter of transmittal is very, very crucial. This letter should have the purpose, why a particular respondent becomes a part of the sample, and request for giving true information or true answers in the tool is necessary. The next step is pilot testing. Once the tool is found to be reliable and valid, it is necessary to give it to a small sample, and whatever is the feedback from this pilot testing or pre-testing of the tool needs to be incorporated in the tool. The most important aspect in a survey research is that many of the respondents, since they are not very close or they are far, may not return back the tool filled in. Therefore, what to do, how to follow up the response, that is very important to be identified before. As well as, suppose there are non-respondents, how to take care of them, or suppose the incomplete filled-in forms, how to take care about that. All these things are very essential in a survey research, which has to be taken care of before the procedure for data collection is started. Once the researcher gets back the filled-in questionnaire or the interview answers, then the next step is to analyze this data and get the conclusions or the result, and the final stage becomes to write the report of the findings. These 10 steps complete the procedure or the steps of conducting a survey research. This slide gives you an overall description or flowchart of steps in conducting a survey research. Now you have come across the different types of survey, the steps of conducting the survey, and therefore you must be aware of what can be the advantages of using a survey research. The very first advantage we can think of is it is cost effective. Even if you are using electronic mail or you are using post mail, it is possible to contact a large number of respondents through the survey, and single questionnaire, which is a standardized form, can be given to all these respondents. And therefore, the cost of conducting survey becomes comparatively less. It is also, you can contact respondents at different places from your own place. There is no necessity actually to go and meet them at distance places. So the cost of travel also is reduced, and therefore surveys become cost effective. The next advantage of survey research is that it is generalizable. After conducting the survey on a sample, the results can be generalized for the entire population because the sample selected can be a representative of the population. Also, it generates data which is empirical and therefore can be used for generalizability. The results of the survey research are very reliable. Since a standardized tool is used to collect information, it is also possible to replicate the research. Because of the standardization of the tool, no subjectivity enters into the research. The respondents' answers can be directly converted into statistical significance and tested. Therefore, we get precise results, and therefore the whole survey research becomes very reliable. Another major advantage of survey research is that it is very, very versatile. It means that it can be used in any field, for any population, for collecting any type of data because of the nature of its type. As we have seen that there are many advantages of survey research, there are some limitations also for this type of research. The most important of that is the inflexibility. Since we are using a standardized tool for data collection, there is no scope for the procedure of data collection as well as the change in the tool. Another most important aspect as a limitation is that surveys are having their limitation in using it for some controversial issues. People are not open, or people may not speak openly about such type of issues, and therefore if a survey is pertaining to any controversial issue or problem, then they are not very useful. The third limitation of survey is because of that standardization, and it is always made considering the general population, it cannot be suitable for some specific respondents, and therefore the respondent's specific ideas cannot be taken into consideration while conducting a survey. Another major problem about a survey research comes because of the validity of the research. Most of the times, suppose the selected sample does not respond to the questions, then the randomness of the sample is at stake. Another problem is there is a tendency of respondents to adhere to some socially accepted rules, and therefore they tend to answer not as what is the actual situation but what is expected of them. It is like a teacher is asked about, do you use innovative methods? Most of the teachers, even if they are not using, will tend to say yes or strongly agree. This is because of the respondents' openness and willingness to answer the questions. They become sort of unopen and unwilling to answer direct personal questions. And sometimes when the respondents do not have any specific answer or they are not willing to answer, they answer it as yes. It's a tendency to say yes or agree. This sort of error is known as acquiescence error. So, after looking at the advantages and limitations, we have to think of how to take care of these limitations of the survey research so that the validity problem will be minimized and the results can be applied to the general populations. While doing so, we have to take some precautions in conducting the research. Let us see what are those precautions. The very first precaution is matching the research question with the type of research method which we are selecting. So, out of the different types of survey, which method will ultimately lead us to getting the correct answers for our question, the research question, is very, very imperative. Second thing is the data analysis procedure and the methods of selection of data analysis and the statistics also should lead to answer the research questions from which we start with. The next thing is reporting of the research findings. Even if what we think may not have resulted, it is ethically written, systematically written report, whether it achieves what the researcher had in mind may not have come into existence, but actual happenings, actual results should be noted in the report. While selection of the sample, the very first thing is to decide about the population or the sampling frame. The second thing is to decide and note the sampling procedure, an appropriate one. And the third thing is to note down the baseline for selecting this particular method of sampling. Whatever the sample selected should be clearly identified, as well as suppose there is some problem with selecting a random sample, what modifications have been performed, that also needs to be explained. In selecting and administering the tool, it is necessary to design a tool which will fetch the answers with which the research has started. Once the tool is prepared, it is to be checked for validity and reliability, which needs to be mentioned in the report. And along with it, the whole procedure of construction and administration of the tool needs to be listed, as well as the tool also needs to be given in the report so that it can be identified whether the questions in the tool really are up to the level which is expected. What is the procedure to obtain the responses and what is the procedure adopted to get high returns of the data needs to be mentioned. With respect to interview, it is necessary to train the interviewer about how to conduct the interview as well as the field interviews are also necessary to be incorporated. Thus, we have seen what is a survey research, what are the different types of survey research, how to conduct a survey research, the steps involved, what are the advantages and limitations of this survey research. Now, try to connect whatever you have learned till now to Uma and the way she has conducted a research in her school. Thank you.